make sure you watch until the end of the video to see how you can win free gear and products. Hey, this is PJ with CLK Supplies, and I'm going to go over everything that you need to know about Vats keys, including the differences between the double and single-sided keys, what ohm values are available, and most importantly, how you can quickly and easily figure out the ohm value of a Vats key with using a cheap multimeter. Let's go ahead and get started. Let's first talk about the difference between a single-sided Vats key and a double-sided Vats key. Now, as you can see here on the left, this is going to be your single-sided Vats key. And all that really means is the cuts on the key are actually only on one side of the key. Whereas this key on the right here, this is the double-sided Vats key. And this blade is going to have cuts on both sides of the key. Now, the ohm chip, the little Vats chip in the middle, okay, those are the same whether it's a single or a double-sided. However, you have to make sure that you're cutting the proper one. Now, visually, you can see they're actually, you know, quite a bit different. The heads on them are different, the length of the blades on them are different, and it's really easy to just identify it just by looking at it really quickly. Now, for this single-sided key, okay, sometimes you'll hear it, you know, referred to as like a six-cut Vats key, and all that means is the actual code series for this single-sided actually has six cuts on the key, whereas the double-sided is sometimes referred to as the 10-cut key, okay? And that means there's actually 10 cuts on each side of this key. It has nothing to do with these Vats chips here, okay? It has everything to do with the keyblade. Now, just for quick reference, the single-sided Vats key, the working key for that is going to be the B62 key, all right? And for the double-sided Vats key, the metal working key is going to be the B86. Now, I'll put a link in the notes below to all these products so you can check them out if you'd like. Now that we know the difference between a single-sided and a double-sided Vats key, let's talk about the actual Vats chip, or should I say ohm resistor, because that's actually what it is. Now, both on the single and the double-sided Vats keys, you're going to see this little resistor in here, commonly referred to as a pellet. All this is an actual ohm resistor, just like this one. And when you're looking at the key, you're essentially looking at it like this. The ohm resistor is right here in the middle. And then on both sides here, you'll see the little contact sticking out, just like the contact here on both sides of this ohm resistor. Now, essentially is what happens when you stick a Vats key into a Vats ignition, there's little contacts on both sides of the ignition that make contact with this ohm resistor in this key, and it completes the circuit. And as long as the right ohm value is in this chip here, that's when the vehicle is gonna start. Now, there is 14 different values available for the double-sided Vats keys. Value number 2 all the way up to value number 15. And on the single-sided key, the same thing applies, except for the values that are available is value number 1 to value number 15, although value number 1 is pretty rare. So all you need to have is a cheap multimeter like this one. You want to make sure you have it set on the capital Greek letter omega symbol, like that right there, and you're going to want to have it set on the 20K setting. And the reason is, if you look at the chart here, you'll see the Vats value number 1 is a 402 ohm, and the number 15 is an 11,800 ohm. So if you have it set on the 200, well, that's not going to pick up any of the Vats key ohms. The 2000 is only going to pick up a few of them, and the next option is going to be that 20K. So that's why you have to have it set on that. Once you have it set on the 20K, you're going to want to go ahead and put it in like a vise or something. I'm just going to set it right here in this slot, and you're going to want to take your contacts, and you're just going to want to put one of the contacts on both sides of that little, the contacts on the chip sticking out here, okay? We're going to get it put on there. We're going to make some good solid connection. It's like that. And then 930, there we go, 945, okay? So the actual number 14 value is a 9,530, and we just got a 9,450, okay? And that's common, and that's okay. So because like the number 13, as you can see, is gonna be a 7,500, and the 15 is 11,800, we know that's close enough to cover for the number 14 VATS key value. So that's the one that we're gonna wanna purchase for that, is that number 14, all right? Now, just like this single-sided one here, let's go ahead and we'll put the contact on both sides. Oop, let's try not to get it to fall in there. Okay, and so that says 52, okay? So since it's set on the 20K setting, that's saying that it's 520. So the number 2 VATS value is a 523. So we know within reason that that's going to be the VATS value that you need. And that is how you can calculate a VATS ohm value with a multimeter. All right, and I hope I've answered all the different questions that you have about VATS keys. Now make sure you go to the notes below this video and download the PDF document that takes all the information that I put in this video and compiled it to a one sheet PDF document to give you everything that you need to know on the fly about VATS keys. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Since you just watched this video, I'm guessing that you work with locks and keys. And to us at CLK Supplies, that makes you a lock boss, unlocking, making, and securing things that people care about. And we wanna hook you up. Here's how it works. Throughout the week, join the conversation and comment on our videos and include the hashtag lockboss. It's free to enter. And every Tuesday, we're gonna pick 5 winners from the previous week and hook you up with a whole bunch of different types of prizes, including gear, tools, supplies. We might send you a key machine or even buy you lunch. So if you're a lock boss, join us every week to learn, grow, and win. All right. Make sure. And that about. And that sums. And that sums up. All right, and there you have it.